Hey guys, it's me, Mr. 250, and welcome back to Miasmata, the land of the man who can't walk downhills. Oh, it's been a couple days since I played this. Hello, giant cockroaches that I can't stab. Sorry about the long break. I was sick, but I'm finally at the point where I'm not sick, or at least unsick enough to the point that I can play and hope I didn't just crash. Okay. We are right here, and we have to travel down this path till we get to Outpost Vega. That's what we were working on last time. Whoops, sorry. I think this zooms me in, actually. Can we not be zoomed in? Okay, cool. Let's make our way over here. Oh, man. Guys, stop running. Got a bit of a marsh over here, don't we? Marshy bit. I don't really want to deal with that. Maybe it's just me, but does this look really zoomed into you guys? Looks weird. Oh, statue thing. It looks weird to me. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Ooh, and we got some flowers, I think. Can I grab these? No, of course not. These aren't the flowers you're looking for. Let's find out where we were. Hold on, now I'm lost. Okay, that's where we were. Let's continue down this path. Hopefully the guy will stop sprinting his way around the jungle. Forest jungle? I don't know. Ooh. Now this looks... Yeah, there we go. Pearl blue shell fungus. Interesting. Actually, you know what I want to do? Because I lost the other one because I was running around and I fell down with it, right? Let's go back to our little tent over here that we were at. I know there was a research station along with... Oh, I like how those sticks sound when you step on them. That's cool. There's a research station and a storage area, which might be nice because I don't really know what it does first off, and I'm afraid I'll lose it falling down another hill or something dumb. We also need more fever medicine. We're totally out of medicine. Totally forgot about that. Anyway, let's examine this. And, oh man, as per usual, we'll skip the canned animation. Let's see what we found. Interesting, so we should be able to synthesize this plant a mental stimulant. Not sure what a mental stimulant would do for our situation, but I do know from looking in our thing that our perception is low, so maybe that'll make us smarter, which might help somehow. Let's store that in the storage bin, that way we can find it wherever. Oh gosh, guy, you're gonna hurt yourself. And, yeah, like I was saying, I suppose mental stimulation is probably important for said guy. Maybe he's not smart enough without it. I don't know. Still kind of nervous. You know, I read all those things about there being some kind of monster on the island, and I haven't seen anything. So I'm still kind of nervous something's going to happen. We have I don't even know what that is. I do notice one thing. Tell me if you guys notice this. It seems to be lagging less. I'm getting a steady 30 to 39 frames, which is way better than before. Before I was chugging at about 20, so I'm liking how this is looking so far. I'm not lagging to pieces. Grab me some flowers. I think these are the ones that help to make the extra strength medicine, if I'm not mistaken. Ooh, and we get some orange ones as well. Cool. These are red. Red and yellow hibiscus. Simple flower. But what are its medicinal properties? Ah, yes. The scientist in us must figure this out. Oh. Doing this one thing, it's trading out constant lag for occasional just stops. Oh. Is it... What time is it? Crap. Dang it, I forgot which button was the watch button. Hold on, give me a second, I need to figure this out. Okay, couldn't find it in the thing. It was weird, it wasn't mapped, but I do remember now. It's right mouse button. It's only 3 p.m. Why is it so dark here? I hope we're going the right way. I can't even remember. Going through some sort of weird structure. Oh, we did find some white flowers. Let me grab those. Still don't know what these are. White spiked prairie flower. I hope Outpost Beg is close by. I might have to do another one of those locating thingies to find myself. Unless the map can show me. Where am I? Oh, great. I have no idea. Okay. Whoa. Okay. I'm really hoping to find another research station soon. I'd like to research these plants and see if they're useful. Maybe even a thingy where I could make medicine at. That would be nice. Oh, I see a tent over here. Is this the research station? Oh, and there's yellow flowers. I'm kind of maxed out on flowers right now. So let's hold off on that for a second while I go over here to this tent. Figure out if this tent's any use. I actually think... Oh, nice music kicking. I think this is the tent that we saw. Yeah, we were over there and I was stumbling around. Oh, crap, I think I have a fever. Oh, dehydration. There's water right here. Drink up, guy. This water's totally safe. Okay. And, yes, it looks like we have a research station. So let's start researching stuff. No, not that one. That one. Skip animation, and... What does this thing do? This flower cannot be used. It's not useful. So, basically, this is of completely no use. Let's find out what this white one does. Basic medicine. Okay, so, whoop, crap. Sorry, keep pressing that button. So, if we combine... How do I get rid of one of these flowers? I don't know how to get rid of the red one, the red useless one. Okay, let's store the pink one, because that one makes it longer. And then we'll store the white one. Yeah, and that could be made to make basic medicine. Oh, crap. Dang it. Well, can I grab it, maybe? No. Is that knife lost forever? Nope. Got it. Okay. Whoops. Let's not do that again. Take that, you, and not their pot. Oh! I'm gonna beat some guy's head in with a pot. Take that, you dirty pot. Oh, it floats! We have a floating metal pot. Ah, that's how you drop flowers. You just have to get close to the ground and then you can drop them. Okay, well, that was some good research right there, I think. Hello, bird things. I did see one more flower over here. I think it was a yellow one. No, these are just not flowers. Oh gosh, guy. Guy, what are you doing? Are you, like, dehydrated? What are you... Are you crawling? I don't think you're crawling. Stop doing that. I don't know what you're doing, guy, but stop it. Oh, man, I'm so lost now. Let's see. Let's try to find where we were. Okay, so... Oh, these were the yellow flowers, I think. Oh, but they're not real yellow flowers, I see. I do have these purplish ones. Did I grab these purplish ones before? I think I have. Yeah. See, what did these ones do? These ones made... I don't know. Let's just keep going. We're sitting at about... 4:30-ish. I'm so lost. Is there any landmarks that we can try to triangulate off of that might be a good idea from here? Nothing. Well, actually, I do know where we're at. Let's see. This was the tent that we looked at from, so we're probably right about here. Yeah, that's gotta be it. Okay, so we're about halfway there. Dang it. So let's just keep running down this path. Wait, why did I pull that out? I don't know. Okay. Yeah, so just keep running down this path, literally running because this character doesn't know how to walk. Oh, we. These ones are different. Orange Prairie. Okay, that's not terribly useful for us, but. Is this a research station? That would be mega useful. Or maybe a house with something in it. Not that houses are too useful to us right now. Pipe bundle. Okay. I'm not really caring what they say about them anymore. That's not important. Ooh. We've got mushrooms in here. Let's see, can we drop the purple one? Oh, crap. That drops everything. Okay, we've got that one. Yes, okay. Can I pick up one of these? Red poisonous mushroom. Great, I'm sure that'll have healthy benefits, right? Okay, so we have poisonous mushrooms living in this cabin that we're visiting. I'm sure that's great. We should try to spend as many hours as we can in here absorbing the spores into our bloodstream and whatnot. Oh guy. There's a monster out in these woods. It's definitely gonna find us with all the noise he's making. I read somewhere apparently it doesn't matter if it's day or night, like you're not really safe from the monster. But I think I'd feel better not traveling at night because at night you can't see. Ah, okay, here we go. Let's do some examinations. Let's examine these orange flowers. Nothing! Great. Okay, so you're not useful. Let's examine you. And basic medicine, okay. So that's another useful one. And mushroom, what does mushroom do? Whoops. Mental clarity tonic. Okay. So if I synthesize that, I get a mental clarity tonic. Interesting. Okay. So, see, that one's the not useful one. Let's not store that away. That one, and then we'll just drop this one. Okay, cool. So we got a bunch of specimens. We need to find a lab. Someplace. Oh, bird. Oh, a note. Let's read the note. Journal entry from Herbert. Number one. I fear I have lost control of what I might do and whom I might harm. Entire days have passed which I do not remember. I have done and said many things in this trance, and I can recall none of it. Even in my ever-dwindling moments of clarity, I find myself directed by some outside force. My hands move and my lips speak, but I am not in control. I am a puppet to some invisible master. And yet I feel euphoria. It compels me to relinquish myself completely to the will of my master. Herbert goes. And some sort of symbol? Looks like page burnt, possibly. Mildly concerning, someone went absolutely crazy. Now, from what I wonder. Oh, I have power of fire. I think apparently if you light these, they save your game as well. Yeah. Not that that's terribly useful to us at the moment, but still. Not a bad idea. Okay, so let's try to guesstimate where we're at right now. I estimate we're probably about right here. So a bit more down the road, and we should be at Outpost Vega. What time are we looking at? Oh, this guy's actually getting kind of dark. Unless that's a weird lighting effect. We're about 6 p.m. I think we can make it down. I do know. Keep in mind. Oh, gosh. Oh, it's lagging. Don't run, guy. Keep in mind, I did watch the YouTube video, you know, as well, so I know how dark the video came out. So, any traveling after 7:30, 8 o'clock-ish should be avoided, because that's just way too dark for us to work with here. I mean, you guys can't see anything. I know you can't. Oh, we have another note. Journal entry from Dr. Sanchez number 2. Oh gosh, that's a lot of words. We have been oppressed by feudalism, then by the old powerful Borghesic, then the army, then the church. Now, as our seedling republic struggles to take root, this miasmata of tyranny begins to coalesce into a pure nationalist order. The same old oligarchy repackaged for popular appeal. How can I blame those who covet this warm nationalist embrace, to desire such peace as promised? Who am I to block the will of the proletariat, so ready to suck at the teat of the callous doctrine, begging to be infantilized by the same tyrant masters. Oh, how the people now talk of peace, and what of this peace? Carlos and his nationalists speak of it in absolute terms, as though their conception of it is benign and self-evident. I say their peace is an oligarch abstraction. It is a meaningless sentiment, made formal by words on paper and enforced by bayonets and gallows in underground cells with wrought iron bars. There is no peace but in death, and those who fight in its name will surely achieve that which they seek, that dark, unmoving, unchanging, forever peace. We will all attain that peace, in our own time and in our own way. There is but misery and comfort in life, and its economy is in trade. There are men who extol that economy, and exchange vast quantities of misery to so many, that they may add meager flecks to their surplus of comfort, a bounty of which is fit for no man but God. Interesting. So, was there some sort of idealized community going on here, possibly? I'm not sure. Regardless, let's continue forth. And when I was looking at that map, I may have confused where we were before for... What? Okay, so I did. We don't actually need that whole system thing, but we are right here right now. So we're not too far, actually. Let's keep going. Let's see, what time is it? 7, almost 30. Let's go to sleep, and if it's not daytime, then we'll go back to sleep, okay? Okay. Just stare at that roof, of course. Okay, of course it's not. About 12:30. Oh man, that's scary. Kinda nervous to go out. I wanna light this fire, though. Cool, okay. Oh, and I didn't say it last time because I didn't notice it, but apparently your character does have a lighter. Oh, why is it so bright over there? Hold on, let me get my knife back. Do you see that? It's really freaking bright over there for 12 at midnight. Why is it so bright? Anyway, let's go back to sleep. I don't want to travel at 12. It'll be difficult for me to see and impossible to see on YouTube. Apparently we take power naps in this game. What are we at now? 6-ish. It'll brighten up, but that's still pretty dark. See, the thing is, if I go to sleep again, it'll be 12, and we'll have wasted away a good portion of the day. So how about this? How about I'll just stay here, let the game run for a minute or two until it's daytime, and then we'll come back. So, yeah, just hang on tight and we'll be there in a sec. Okay, we're back again. It's a bit brighter. I think I can work with this. I don't know, it's like 7:30 in the morning. I think there's enough contrast that you guys can see. We'll continue on our way to Outpost Vega. Hopefully not get murderized by something, anything. And I think I see what happened with the video. It didn't fully fill up my screen. There's like black bars on top. Whoa. Did you hear that? Oh man, that stopped me dead, didn't it? We saved, okay. Well, we saved, so I think we'll be okay. Let's investigate that. Yeah, but I think the screens just didn't fill up correctly, and that's why I'm getting a weird view. Heard a roar of some sort, I think. What was that? Is that the monster? I'm like on edge right now. Why am I playing this again? It's 10:30 at night. I need to go do something more productive, like, I don't know, something not scary. Oh, what is that? Is that just a cut off bit of tree? Yeah. I know I definitely heard something roar. Oh, crap. Guys, stop running. Whatever that thing is gonna hear you if you're sprinting full out. And I initially said I liked how those things sounded when you crinkle stepped on them. I don't like them anymore. They're just making me nervous. I think I can do some triangulation here. Is that something? Maybe not. Is that a bird? Yeah, no, that's a beaver, I think. Can't triangulate off of that because I don't know what it is yet. Or where it is, anyway. Okay. I think that's a beaver. I think it's another one of the creatures in this game. Ooh, seagull. Bye, seagull. Something really red right there. Let's go figure out what that is. Well, I did hear a roar, but it appears to be gone now, and I think this might be more of those mushrooms. The ones for the stimulant. Since we're not holding anything, I guess we might as well grab more, right? I don't know what a mental stimulant does yet. Oh, we got some more of this. Actually, I think this is stuff I picked up the first time that I dropped. Yeah, it is. So we still need to figure out what this is. Look at that. Oh wow, it's really cloudy over there, but I was gonna say, look at that. This place is nice. I mean, the people who made this game, they did a nice job, you know, just sort of putting the whole thing together. I'm absolutely positive I heard it that time. Oh, your heartbeat. Oh, do you see that? Do you see that? It's over there. Is there a way I can hide from it? No. Let's just not go to Outpost Bag anymore, guys. We're done. The heartbeat stopped. And this is where I normally say, okay, guys, I'm so scared. We're gonna be done now and pansy out, but there's no save station nearby, so... Let's go up and see if he's still there. Maybe he wandered off. I heard it again. So I'm gonna tell you, I've been kind of lying to you guys a little bit. I do know a little bit about this. I did some research. The heartbeat that you hear, I think, means that you are within seeing distance of him. However, it's not likely he'll see you unless you're close. I didn't know about that roar. That roar scared the crap out of me. And you can't fight him, which is why it's kind of pointless to carry this knife. The best you can do, I think, is throw something and distract him. And if you distract him, then you can run away. He does appear to have gone away. Where is he? Oh, he's up there. Oh crap, he sees me! Go, 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 go! Go, 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 go. Oh, oh no, oh no, oh no, go, 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 guy. Go, go. Okay, you can use your running skills. Please run, please run. Run, run, guy, run. Run, run. Run, guy, run. Oh gosh. Oh, be gone. I don't care if I'm fatigued. Run, dude, run. Can he come up here? This is my only hope if he can't come up here. Oh. You see him? Kind of green, actually. Oh. Okay. We're not going and getting any water. This is stupid. I'm gonna drink some here. Okay. Ooh, this is actually a research station. How handy. While we're hiding from a monster. He doesn't appear to be coming up these stairs. That's really actually fantastic for us. Let's just drop, actually. I think this was to make some sort of mental stimulant, so let's just do that really quick. We already got that, didn't we? Oh, yeah, it's just a reiteration. Okay, let's make some medicine really quick while we're being stalked by a monster outside. Clarity tonic. The tonic temporarily boosts your self-awareness. Location on the map will be revealed continuously for the duration of the tonic. Ah, so that helps me with telling where I am. That's really good. This guy's not gonna leave, is he? Okay, well... I'm sure this is a fairly unorthodox way of... dealing with the monster, but we're gonna do it. something of island medicines. I can't see that hand. Basic medicine. Oh, so this is all the medicines we can make. Okay. Eliminates fever, endurance emphasis drug, one-time use drug, permanently allows you to run further before reaching exhaustion. Oh, so that's a permanent upgrade. That would be useful. Permanently produces strength. You can sprint faster and swim further. That's another useful sounding one. Permanently allows you to sense if an enemy's presence and know if you are well hidden. That would be useful, because as you can tell, I didn't know that guy was there until I was too late. Energy stimulant, temporary drug, allows you to run further before exhaustion. That sounds like a temporary one-time use. Clarity tonic, location on the map is revealed for the tonic's duration, which, might I remind you, was made with a poisonous mushroom. Heroicin tonic, allows you to sprint swiftly and swim longer distances, temporarily, of course, and temporarily allows you to sense the creature's presence, which I assume is that thing running outside, and know if you're well hidden. Okay, so that's good. Give me a knife. So I guess we could do some testing with him while we're here. So can I save? I think I can save with this number. Does that save? No, that doesn't save. So there's no way I can save. That's delicious. Anyway, let's take something non-important, like, I guess it's a knife. I might need it later, but I want to test it out before I do something dumb. So if, I kind of saw it, but I wasn't sure, if you throw something, that'll distract him temporarily, so let's try that. Maybe he was busy. It does look like we could go that way to escape the creature. That's where we're going to go next, just so you know. But, I would love to make a second video, but I'm so freaked out right now by that thing. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to try some way to save, and then we're going to get out of here. But while we're here, let's synthesize. So this is going to be a long episode. I apologize already. Let's see. Actually, let's figure out what all this crap does. Mental stimulant. Okay. That's what this should make. Mental stimulant. Temporary boost to your QD, providing following benefits to your interaction with the creature. So hold sneak and keep still. Your head will automatically turn and face the direction. And then while holding it, an overlay will appear on screen. The opacity of the overlay is proportional to the creature's proximity to you. If it turns from red to white, you are not well hidden, and it will be able to see you if he's looking in your direction. Let us grab that, definitely. Okay, I forget what this is. This is not the blue shell fungus, whatever the other fungus was. Gray shelf. Oh, we weren't able to do any science on it, so let's do some science. No, that's not helpful. What does it do? What does it do? Okay, you perform research. This is another mental stimulant, so let's make some more mental stimulant while we're here. Why not? I mean, I suppose apparently this running into this creature is a common occurrence, so we're not going to have a case of having it too much. So what did this... This one was the basic medicine, right? So I think if we combined it with the other one... No, wait, no, that... What is this? Here, let's just re-research it really quick so I can figure it out. Is it basic medicine? Okay, so that's basic medicine. I think, is this white one basic medicine as well? What about the purple one? I can't remember now. I don't want to spend forever looking these up, so I'll just re-research them. Fine. No, fine, do your animation if that'll make you work correctly. All while having a super beating heart. No, it won't make you work correctly. Excellent. That's great. It was a white spike prairie flower. There we go. Yeah, so these are both basic medicines. So what is that? Do you make a super basic medicine if you put two of them in, or do you make two of them? I'm kind of curious what happens if you start making things not by the book. Oh, no useful medicinal agent was synthesized. Okay, so you just waste your ingredients if you try to do that. Okay, so we're almost done synthesizing items. I still need fever medicine. We have basic fever medicine, but we know that won't hold us long. We have a nice combo of items, a mental stimulant, clarity tonic, all good. So I'll use the clarity tonic if I get lost, is how that'll work. Actually, I should have two of them now, once I do this. So, we have two clarity tonics. At least I think they stack. That guy's just been running out there. I found a bug, guys. He doesn't get you if you stand up here. Yeah, so we're gonna try to exit stage right out here and see if he can't follow us. Ooh, actually, what are these flowers? Are these ones I just made the basic medicine with? That'd be nice to get a small stockpile of basic medicine. Let's just make one more. Can't jump through the window, of course. That's too hardcore for Mr. Sickly Old Man Guy Scientist. Yeah, so we got some basic medicine. Good, we have two. That'll last us for a bit. Now, hopefully, the monster can't see us over here. Although I still hear the heartbeat, so I feel like he can see us. He's not following us. Let's go up to this house. Maybe there's a save point. That would be lovely. Oh, that sound's finally gone too. That's nice. Oh, relaxing music. Isn't that nice? Oh, we've got artwork up here. Oh, this must have been some painter guy. Let's just step on his artwork. A map to bioluminescent algae. I discovered this curious algae last evening as I returned to Vega from my research station at Ruin Site B. It has property of brilliant bioluminescence during the day. It is impossible to discern this algae from the mossy tufts of the surrounding bog, but at night it shines brightly via some apparent biochemical process, and I hope he finds this useful. That might be useful to us. I have a feeling that these are supposed to be drawings of the monster in question. Got a nice painting spot though, look at that, he could like get a nice painting of this room out here. Unfortunately, as you could probably guess, this is where I'm going to stop for today. Use a lot of time synthesizing and whatnot. So anyway, I'm Mr. 250, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!